Hey there, welcome back to the channel for another video. Thank you so much for making time to watch this video. I hope everyone is safe and sound and healthy at this time of pandemic. So moving forward, if you have watched my last video, then I have mentioned there that I would be doing a restoration on my old Bajaj Super scooter that we own. So this is the very first video of the restoration project. I'll be making a playlist, so you make sure that you subscribe to the channel and hit that bell icon so that you get notified every single time I upload a video to this channel. So today I'll be just trying to start the scooter and I'll be doing a full restoration job on the scooter. That will be a stock restoration, not some crazy modification, because it's an old classic scooter and I like everything remain to the original shape. So obviously a original stock restoration I'll be performing on the scooter, but right now as lockdown is currently in our state Assam, so I can't do the paint and denting job on the scooter. So that said, let's not waste time sitting inside the house and let me show you the scooter or take you near to the scooter, and then I will refill it, because it's been sitting for almost 5 years and there's no fuel in the tank, and I hope that it is in a perfect condition so that fuel doesn't leak out of the tank. I'll try to refill it and then I'll try to start it. So without any further delay, let's get going. So here I am out with my scooter, and this is the Bajaj Super scooter that I have been talking about. Solid metal, so there are light rust issues over the top surface. I'll show you, I'll take you around the scooter, and then today I'll be trying to refill it because its tank is completely empty, and then try to start it. Hopefully it gets started without the help of any mechanic. So without talking, let me show you the scooter, the condition, how it is right now. So the lights, okay, every light is working. I checked it, like putting on the key and giving it some kick starts. So because there is no fuel, it won't start. So there is no major rust issues, like fenders are all good. It just need paints, and there's the plastic horn cover, so the paint has came out of here. Then the meter is working, but there are few rust issues, so I have to make this correct. The seat covers are all gone, so this is totally gone, I have to change it. But the rear seat cover is in a very great condition. Hope I can use it, or if I'll be changing this one, I hope I'll change this one. Then the spare wheel cover is all gone, then there are the chrome is all gone from these guards. This time I won't chrome it, but let me know in the comment section if I should chrome it or paint it black, because I'll be going for the same color. This is a gray color, I'll be going for the same color in this scooter. I want to do matte gray. So with matte gray, this chrome, I don't think it will go great, so I'll be doing some matte black in these guards and all, without talking anymore. So let me now put on fuel. Hope you can see it, there's no fuel in the tank and it's totally empty. There's not even a lock in these fuel tanks, but hopefully there is a filter. I don't think you can see it, but it's totally empty. So the thing with these two-stroke scooters are that they don't run on pure petrol, like you have to mix some parts of oil. So if you have watched my last video, then I've shown you I brought oil, like this oil is called Tuti. You have to mix some parts of oil with the fuel. So first I will do that, then I will put on the fuel into the scooter. So I have mixed the oil in the petrol in these gallons, so let's now refill the scooter. I won't be putting all the fuel into the tank and hope there's no leakage, because the scooter has been sitting in the fuel tank, was empty for like 3 to 4 years. So let's now refill it. So let's check. Let me check how much will. Okay. There's enough. But it will be in reserve. I'll again put fuel later on. Now let me turn on the fuel knob to the on position. Then I'll open up the side cover or the engine cover. Yeah, there you go. It's all dirty. Now the trick to start a two-stroke scooter is that you have to tilt the scooter to some degree, like 30 to 40 degree towards yourself. Then the fuel from the tank will come to this carburetor, and then hopefully it will start. Let's do that. Let me tilt more and let me tilt it for some time. Okay, I think that will work. Now pulling that choke, then give it a kick. Two, that's two kicks. Three, four, five, six. It didn't work with 10 kicks, so I have to now open up the carburetor and then also clean the spark plug. So what I do is now open up the carburetor and the spark plug and then try to see if it will start or not. So after trying for like around 30 kicks, I couldn't start the scooter. Even my father tried, couldn't start the scooter, but there's a problem that came up, and nothing major. We need to change one thing. That's it. The ignition coil has busted out, so we need to change the ignition coil, and hopefully after that everything will get to normal. I will be able to start the scooter. So day one couldn't start the scooter. Hopefully I will buy a ignition coil tomorrow and install it back to the scooter, and then let's see if we can start it or not. So back inside the home again, after 30 to 40 kicks, I couldn't able to start the scooter. I stopped counting at last, because it was around 30 or 40 kicks for sure. I couldn't start the scooter because there was a problem, and obviously for sitting like for 3 to 4 years, any vehicle will have some problem in starting up. So I changed the spark plug, also I cleaned the old one, tried it, didn't work out. Then I changed and installed a new spark plug which I had already, that didn't work out. Then I opened the carburetor, cleaned the jets with petrol, that didn't work out. So at last there was only one thing that was damaged, because the current was not coming to the spark plugs, and the only thing that have gone wrong would be the ignition coil. So here it is. Here's the ignition coil that I took out of the scooter. So I have to put a new ignition coil, then hopefully the scooter will start. So day 2, scooter restoration, going out to buy the ignition coil for the scooter. I hope that I will find it in one of the shop. Also the shops are going to close soon, so I have to go fast. I got up little late today, so my bad, I have to do the things fast. And hope every one of you are doing good. So let's see if I can buy the ignition coil or not, or I'll get it or not for the specific scooter that I am doing the restoration process on. I am getting near to the shop, so let's just slow down and here is the shop, so let's see if we can find it or not. Hey, ignition coil আছে নি স্কুটার বাজাজ সুপার কোড পাম বাৰু জানে নে কলেজ তিনি আলি সো দা ফার্স্ট শপ আই ডিডন্ট গট দা ইগনিশন কয়েল লেটস নাও গো টু অ্যানাদার শপ এন্ড ট্রাই ইফ উই ক্যান ফাইন্ড ইট অর নট Because I have to find it. Without the ignition coil, the scooter will not start and I won't be able to take it to the paint shop and the denting and painting shop. There is the shop. Let's just ask it there if I can find the ignition coil or not. Bajaj Super ignition coil hobo niki? Bajaj Super ignition coil hobo niki? Twist coil no hobo. So my bad, couldn't find the ignition coil in Nazira itself, so now I have to go to another place called Simaluguri. Hope I can find it there. So going to Simaluguri. দাদা এই টু ষ্ট্ৰক স্কুটাৰৰ কিবা ৰাখে নেকি টু ষ্ট্ৰক স্কুটাৰ কাৰেণ্ট কইলটো ৰাখে নেকি নাই ক'ত পাম ইয়াত গম পাই নি মেইন ৰোডত Please, I hope I get it. Bajaj Super ignition coil pump ni ba ki ba ke? Bajaj Super ba cheta kor. কেবুলডাল আছে, কিন্তু সেই বস্তুটো বেয়া হৈ গ'ল মানে। একেলগে আহে গতিত দিছ ৱাজ দ্য অল্ড ওৱান, দিছ ইজ দ্য নিউ ওৱান। So back to home, and after running from like 3 to 4 shops, like searching in 2 shops in Nazira and 1-2 shops in Simuluguri, I finally got this, the ignition coil for the scooter that sitting beside me, right? So this was the old ignition coil that I removed yesterday, and today I am going to install the new ignition coil. Here it is. So hopefully after installing this the scooter get started. So let's begin the installation process. So for installing the ignition coil I need a number 8 spanner set, so doing that right now. So even after installing a new CDI, the ignition coil, sorry not CDI, the ignition coil, my father and I couldn't get the scooter started. So final solution, we have called a mechanic. He's actually one of my uncle and he has a scooter workshop. So hopefully he will try to get it started today evening, and that's it. That's the progress till now. So as we couldn't start the scooter, I had to call one of my uncle. He's very good at repairing two-stroke scooters, and he has a repairing shop in Nazira itself. So he came and he told that there is an issue with the coil of the scooter. So right now he's working on that. কইল কারেন্টটো নোহোৱা হৈছে ন? কার্বন নাইকিয়া হৈ গ'ল নি? Starting the scooter for the very first time. Lots of adjustment to be done, and this is the first time we have started the scooter after 4 years. So just listen to that two-stroke note. Finally, after trying for many times, the scooter got started. luckily there was some issue with the ignition coil or the starter coil, which is the capacitor. Actually my uncle did, and then there's a thing that needs to be changed, and it's called the pickup, starter pickups. There's a something called pickup point, so that needs to be changed. It will run, but he has told us that if it's changed, then it will be much more better in running the scooter. So I'll now put on everything back to its place. So finally, after working for 3 days, I was able to start the scooter. Not me, I took help of my uncle, as you have seen earlier in the video. So had to change few things that he recommended. So some of the things that I changed are, this is a part from the carburetor. So due to over tightening of the fuel pipe, this has got some cracks and fuel is leaking from here. Then the next thing that I changed was the capacitor from the current coil. Then one more thing that he told or asked to change was this current pickup point from the current coil or the alternator. It's basically called current coil in these scooters. So this was the pickup point, and it has gone. It was damaged because there is no contact portion here. Hope you can see it. So these are the things that I have changed from the scooter to make it start. There is one more thing that I've changed, that is the fuel tip, but I cannot show it right now. The old one is totally busted because there was no fuel in the fuel tank for like 4 years. So it got damaged. So I installed a new one, and now everything is working fine. So let me now just take you to the scooter and let's go for a short ride and show you some more things on the scooter that I have changed or I have added. It's completely stock till now, and hope I will keep it that way. But that's it. Let's now go out and show you the scooter and how it looks. Hope you like it. So here it is. This is the scooter after the engine has been rebuilt. So I have installed new mirrors by installing brackets here. They were placed from places where the brackets can be installed. The headlights needs to be installed because the reflector, the silver element from the reflector has all rusted out, because these headlights are made of metal. So I'll be changing that, making another video or showing in another video. Then remove the rear seat, because the lower part of the rear seat was made of cardboard. So because of water coming into while washing, and it has all rotten out. Then every single lights are working. The number plate needs to be changed with a newer number plate. I have applied that in the RTO office, so I'll be installing that. Then there are rust issues, but it's not that major. Rust issues here and there. So these side guards and all, I'll be changing this portion or painting them black, and thinking to paint the scooter with the same color, like gray. Thinking of going metallic. Then there are some denting works needed to be done here. So that's it. So now let's see if we can start it or not. Let's turn on the fuel, and then we have to tilt the scooter. This scooter needs to be tilted, and then let's hope it gets started in the first kick itself. Yes. So where it is. So now let's not waste much time and go out for a ride, and let me grab my helmet and let me see you out on the road. So here I am, mounted my camera on the helmet. Now let's go out for a short ride. Aren't we going long? I have refilled it, but I won't be going for a longer ride today. I'll be making another video on that. Nice, it got started within the first kick. Oh damn, it again went out. So let it start again. Let's get it started. Okay. Oh, that smell of two stroke and the sound of two stroke. So let's go for a short ride then. Let me check if the camera is recording or not. Yes, it's recording. So let's go. So these scooters have hand shifters or click shifters in the hand. So here's the first gear, then slowly release the clutch and let it go. Sorry, riding after many years. So that sound, I hope it's getting recorded in the camera. So these scooters go fast, hope you can see. I nearly touched 60, but there's a risk going fast in these scooters because this particular Bajaj Super that I am riding at now has only has only 8-inch wheels, which are very small, so can't take risk. Also the brakes are not that good, so you can go till 80 km per hour, but the brakes will literally kill you. That's the charm of this scooter, everybody looks at you like whoever is around, and after removing the rear seat it gives the scooter more classic charm, and also the mirrors are working great. At least at higher speeds they are not giving much vibration like the Bullet, so better than Bullet or the classic 350. Sorry Bullet riders or the fanboys, but this is the truth. Oh, love that sound. Nothing can match a two-stroke sound. This thing is pretty nimble because the wheel size is very small, so they are pretty nimble. Also, that's how the horn sounds. It's an AC horn, it doesn't run on DC, so that is how it sounds. Speed breakers. Okay, there's issue with the front brake because if I apply it to slow down, it doesn't go back to its original position. Are cows. From 40 km per hour in the third gear itself. The engine is quite powerful because it's a 150cc scooter, so I think the horsepower is around 7 to 8 bhp. The top figure is also the top figure will be around 8 Nm or 9 Nm stock. But that's enough because these scooters are pretty light, 110 kilos or something. Oh, that shifting sound. It feels so good to ride this scooter after so many years. Like nearly 5 years. I haven't ridden it for nearly 5 years. this was the thing. I started riding and got now, I mean, I started learning scooters and bike by riding this particular scooter when I was in like around class 6, I guess. So there's lots of memories with this scooter, so we can never sell it. So I restored it. Okay, the video is I think getting longer, so I cannot show you all the things or the whole ride to make it short, or it will be annoying for you, I know that. So this was the restoration, first restoration video of this scooter. So you have watched, if you have watched the video till now, and if you have liked the video, then give it a thumbs up. Also don't forget to subscribe to my channel and press that bell icon so that you get notified every single time I upload a new video. Also I'll be continuing this restoration project on this particular scooter, so make sure you press that bell icon. So that's it for today. So back to home after this short ride and super happy with the progress. The scooter is riding very nicely. There's no issue at all right now. There's few some issue with the front brake. I'll be making that okay or showing it by showing it to some mechanic. This video is already getting too long. So if you have watched the video till now, then make sure you like the video. Also subscribe to my channel and don't forget to press that bell icon so that you get notified whenever I make new uploads to this channel. So that's it for today. So thank you so much for watching this video.